In this video, we will see how Fedina first-time users can access Fedina. As an administrator of Fedina, you will be getting a URL using which you can access the Fedina web application. When you open that URL, you will be prompted to enter username and password. For the first time, admin must log in into the system so that the settings can be done and the other users, which are employees, and students can be created. By default, the password of the admin will be admin123. If you have changed the password after logging in for the first time, you can use that password to log in here. As a first-time user, the administrator can manage what he wants to see on the screen. You can see small dashlets which appear here, and each dashlet gives you some information about the institute. The dashlet can be managed by going to this option, and you can choose what you want to appear on the dashboard. The information about a particular dashlet can be seen for the current date, any previous date. You can also select a particular date by selecting from the calendar. You can minimize or maximize the dashlet using this option. If you have done any changes particular to a dashlet, that can be refreshed and checked from here. Now, as a first-time user, you can see the menu option to check what all features are available inside Fedina. On clicking on the menu icon, you can see that the modules and the functionality of Fedina is divided into academics, collaboration, data and reports, administration, and apps. Each of these modules have functionality particular to them. For example, under academics module, you can find marking of student attendance, application of leaves, checking of calendar and events, library function, timetable creation, and other modules. Under collaboration, you can check blog, Google Docs, news, gallery, and other modules. Data and reports will show you reports related modules. Reports will give you the reports about the batches, exam, fee collection, subject details, and many other. You can manage the data by keeping records using data management. Data export will allow you to take the backup of the data that you have entered in Fedina. You can create custom reports for employees and students. Custom import will help you import bulk data about student, employees, parents, and other modules using this option. Under administration, you will see administrative related activities. General settings can be done. You can create courses and batches. You can set up the student pre-settings. You can set up online payment gateways, transport, fees, inventory module, and human resource module. Under apps, you can set up apps which can be third party and can be integrated with Fedina. These all options are available for an administrator. These options get restricted based on the role of the user. For the student, restricted number of options are available. For an employee, these options, which should be made visible to the employee, can be set by the administrator. You also have quick links option where you can set which all modules you use frequently. That can be managed by using this option of manage quick links. You can choose the options that you want to see under the quick links option and save the same. Also, on the top right, you will see this inbox icon. This is the internal message system of Fedina. When you click on it, you will be able to see the messages that you receive. You can also create messages and see the messages that you have sent. Using the internal messaging system, the users of Fedina can communicate with each other. As an administrator, you can create messages for employees of any department, students of any batch, and the parents of any students. This sending of messages is restricted based on the role of the user. As an administrator, you can message any user in Fedina. You can compose the message by mentioning the subject and the content, and also you can attach a file which you want to send to the recipients. The maximum size of this file that is allowed will be 5 MB. After you send this message, the recipients, when they log in into their Fedina, can check their inbox and can check the details about your message. They also get an option to reply to the message that you have sent them. As an administrator, you can check your details by clicking on the top right avatar. Here you can see it gives you an option to change the password or view the profile. Let us change the password. By default, the administrator is given the password admin123. When the admin first logs in, he can change this password and update it. In this case, the admin will be now able to log in using the new password. If there are more than one administrators which are going to use Fedina, new administrators can be created by going to Administration, User. Here you will see this option on the top right, which is Add New. You can give the username of the new admin, let's say admin1, the first name, the password for this admin, and the email, and you can create it. So along with admin, another administrator will be admin1. In the same way, you can create multiple administrators. In the next video, we will see how the administrator can do the general settings. That is the first functionality that the administrator should perform when he starts configuring Fedina for the institution.